What up? Budden here. Listen, I want to do a kind of an update video. The DIY project I worked on a while back of the inverter with the batteries and a battery charger and shit. I'm going to put it right now. The battery charger was junk. So I had to take it apart and apologize for the snuff in my teeth, but I just spit a dip out. So y'all going to have to deal with the black shit in my teeth right now. I didn't get a chance to rinse my mouth out. So I kind of want to show you what I did and how I changed it around and how I'm able to do this, okay? So let me pause this, turn it around, and I'll show you what I did. First off, I'm going to walk over here and show you. I don't know if you guys can read that. And I don't even know if I'm on it. All I see is glare, so I don't even know if I'm on it. This is 13.3. So here's what I did. Here's the inverter that I bought. I took the clamps and put onto the end of the inverter so I can take the inverter off at the end of the night and I can shut this and lock it. I need to find a box to put this in, to mount it in, so I can mount it on the side or something, or even on the top of this. But all I did was mount it in here. I got a smart charger because the batteries are a little weak. So I want to do what I can to see if I can charge up these batteries a little bit. But here's what I did. Sorry for the wind. Here's my water. Okay, so I have my cord, and I'm using a battery or a tire cover for my inverter or my generator. So what I did is I plugged the RV into this, and I turned this on, and the RV has a converter which helps the batteries. It helps maintain the batteries, which if you're like me, you know that the batteries or the converter that's in these RVs are not the best in the world. Excuse me. But it does help. So what I did is I got this charged into here, and then I can run all the electrical. I just run a cord into the window, which is probably not a good idea, but I do it and it works. But I've got everything ran and I got everything set up to where it runs, and then I can run this off of it. I just went and got a new spark plug and oil and everything for this today so I can change it out. This is actually overkill for what I need, but it works, so I'm not going to bitch and complain. But this is how I got it set up right now. The only thing I can do now is a little bit different. I wanted to show you this. Say hi! So this is how I got this set up. Lucky helped me. Lucky did most of it because I can't walk very well. So, but this... Huh?
If they think it looks horrible, you did it.
It actually looks good. And you're probably going to wonder, like, if I don't know if you can see it. But you see the little slits in the back? We did that for airflow. Now, you might think I'm crazy, but the wind does kick up here. So what we did is we took Gorilla Tape, white Gorilla Tape, and we put it on both sides. We put it on the inside and the outside, and then we took a knife and just slit so that way wind can go through here. That way it's not ripping the awning. But the Gorilla Tape, it's done pretty well so far. So, but we got everything, we got it strapped down here on the corners, and we have a stake. If you can see those stakes that I bought, it's staked down there, so the ratchet strap's there. The ratchet strap's there, and we got it all. It may not be the prettiest thing in the world, but it works. And then we have the other ratchet strap. This right here is a funny story, and I have to tell you. If we take this off, this sounds like a helicopter. Like, literally, it'll flap in the wind, and it'll go... It sounds like a helicopter. Lucky didn't like that. She thinks a helicopter's coming, and they're trying to take her away or something. It's like the military, off to drag her off into the fucking military base. So...
It literally sounds like you have a helicopter outside idling with, you know.
So, this right here keeps this from her, it keeps her sanity sane or whatever you want to call it. But anyway, we got it all marked up. Oh, and then we changed the lettering on here. I don't know if you can see that, but instead of saying
Happy Rednecks,
Happy Rednecks, it says Traveling Rednecks. And then Lucky took, let's see if I can zoom in on this a little. T-R-A-V-E-L-I-N. And Lucky redid the heart because the heart, oh my god, you should have seen the heart before she redid it.
It looked like a monkey wrote it.
It looked like a monkey's ass is what it looked like.
I'm serious. If
it
you
looks
see
like a monkey's butt print.
You if you seen that heart before she redid it, it actually looks good now, but before, oh my god, it was hilarious. It looked like a pair of ass cheeks was hanging out like it was underground, and all you could see is two bony ass cheeks sticking up. It was freaking hilarious.
Oh my goodness.
But anyway, so we got the light ran here, and this is from the that light. Oh, let me back this back. Oop, yep, back that back out.
That's our board game light.
That's our board game light. And what we do, we got that run into the charger. See, and that's why I like the Harbor Freight, because you get these two lights. And I'm going to tell you what, this little son of a gun is bright at night and helps us in, oh, Lucky's artwork.
Oh.
Lucky's artwork. Lucky's artwork. I don't know if you can see it. It says Lucky in green with a four-leaf clover.
I like to doodle.
And she likes to paint rocks. So she painted rocks. Show them the other one.
This one's a little dirty.
This is another one she did.
This one's a little dirty.
Love one another. And this one's been sitting out in the dirt, but it has our last name. And then Tomorrow Isn't Promised, which is another one of our sayings. And then here's the redneck side. So we had to cut the bottom of the tarp off over here so we could roll it up. And I've still got to redo that because it looks like crap really bad. But we had a small piece, and we always had cold air coming in. And it gets down into the, you know, the high 30s, the low 40s at night. So what we did is just took this and put some packing tape on. I know I'm going to get static for that. No, that's
the redneck fixing of my chairs.
That's red. Oh, yeah. That's Gorilla Tape on her chair because it all ripped. It's a cheap chair. Her chair all the way ripped out.
It was ripped before I put my fat ass on it.
So you can see the little bit of a rip here. But we just took Gorilla Tape and taped it all the way back on both sides because it was ripping out. And the Gorilla Tape is actually on the bottom too. And it
doesn't exactly form to my butt like the chair did.
I redneckify everything, okay? So everything we have is redneckified. And I also got her a 12-volt thing in her bed. Let me go show you that. And our bed's a mess, so I'm going to go show this to you real quick. Would you like to be on camera? Would you like to be on camera? You want to say hi to everybody? Oh, say hi. I'm Miss Piggy, and I don't get along with people very well, but I am so pretty. She loves me so much. Now she'll sit, when I sit at my chair, she will actually jump up on my lap and sit down there while I'm farming, which is cool. Oh, and this is for all you Chevy guys. I made this a while back, and I'm going to stick it right there in the middle. And then hopefully you guys can follow me. I know it's going to sound really messed up. Okay, I did the wiring on my thing that's underneath my nightstand. I don't know if you can see it over there, but it's underneath. So I did 12 volt. So what I did, I took the light out and I ran wires. Oh god. And I got to flip this way. And you can see she has a 12 volt now. And what I did was I took a piece of baling wire, which rednecks, we have duct tape and baling wire. And if we don't have either one, we're screwed. Because I took the baling wire, ran it over here to the opening, and then fed the line through here. So now she has a 12 volt outlet on her side of the bed. That's where she wanted it. And there's a little gap that's right here. That's on this, there's a shelf on the inside, and then this covers the outside. So there's a little opening that goes all the way across to there. So I ran the wiring through there, so that way she could have a 12-volt outlet on her side of the bed, and I could have one on my side. So, and then we had an issue with this light bulb. It keeps flickering, and we have no clue why. This side doesn't flicker. It works great. But we've tried new bulbs and everything else. If anybody has an idea why just this one side flickers all the time, and we don't understand it. So we just took the bulb out, and we only have the one light now. But it won't stop flickering. It doesn't matter what bulb we put in it or anything. It always flickers. So if you guys have any ideas, let me know. So that way I can figure it out. But this is what I've been working on. This was an easy job because I could literally lay in bed and do it. didn't have to walk very much. So, you know, there's what I'm trying to get around on right now. There's my smart charger I bought. Oh, I know you don't like looking at my canned foods, and I'm kind of half crooked. Well, I'm half crooked anyway, but it's a smart charger. What I want to do is try to use the reconditioning setting on this charger to try to recondition my batteries a little bit better. Here for the longest time, let me turn this around real quick. Here for the longest time, excuse me, we just got done eating breakfast with Mike, and those of you know him as Old Man Mike. Mike Reno is his name.
Dirty Old Man Mike.
Dirty Old Man Mike, Funny Mike, whoever.
He's anyway. Now Doorman Mike.
Yeah, he's now Doorman because he was holding the door for Lucky the entire time we was out. So he would hold the door for her. And I know I'm not going to hear the end of this. Well, why didn't you hold the door? Because I'd rather hit her with it.
You have.
I'm just teasing. I do open the door
he's
for
not
her.
Teasing.
Whatever.
You'd much rather hit me.
See what I have to put up with? So anyway, we ate with Old Man Mike, so I'm kind of burping a little bit. But the thing we've been doing, not for where I was going with that.
Ew. Maybe you should pause it and play it back for yourself.
Pause it and play it back for myself so that way I can go.
Ugh. You can remember what you were talking about.
So we've been dealing with not having, the batteries were not staying charged. And they would go to like 12.1. The lowest they got was 11.9 or 11.8. 11.8. As soon as they hit 11.8, that's when I knew there was a problem. And then I went and got the distilled water, filled it back up. But ever since we filled them back up and we've been having them on charge, and I turned the generator on, and with the solar, they're now staying up at 13.3. I would like to have them at 13.8. What are you looking at and what are you trying to do? Anytime she gets close to me, I always wonder because 9 times out of 10, when she gets close to me, she tries fucking with me. And now she's laughing. I hope you pee yourself. So anyway, so we had problems with it staying charged. So I got the distilled water, filled the batteries back up, and I've been keeping it charged with the converter from the generator. And the batteries are actually gaining power, if that makes any sense. So they would stay at like 12.3 to 12.5, and they did that for a while. Now, since I've done that and refilled them up with distilled water, now it's up at 13.3 and 13.5. So I'm really happy that it gained that much. So the next plan is I cleaned out the storages underneath the storage compartments in the front of the RV, and I'm going to try to get everything from in the truck bed of Betty, and I'm gonna try to get it moved in there. And we've got to go get a few things, and I don't even know right now what we're gonna do. I know we're staying here, and I think we're gonna go up to Flagstaff and visit her daughter for Christmas. We'd like to go up to Utah, but we know we can't afford to do that. So we're going to do what we can and just get a few things that would help us out. And that's about it. I got some small projects coming up that I'm going to try to work on. Like I said, my back and my knee have been giving me a shit ton of problems lately. I'm actually making a decal for Beach Cricket. I don't know if any of y'all know her. I've got it all made up on the plotter, and I've got to get it made up. I've got to get the plotter out of the back of the truck so I can get it made up for her. Actually, there's two of them. She wanted two decals made, so I made her one to go across her RV, well, shuttle bus. So I'm not going to tell you what they are. When you see Beach Cricket, you will be able to see what I did. And that's it. I don't know what else to write now. Kind of losing words. And I know Rylander will give me shit about this because I just ramble on sometimes. So, Rye, love you, buddy. Anyway, so stay tuned. You don't know what's going to happen next. I don't know what we're going to do later on today. I know I've got to get those decals done, like I said. We're trying to get a website set up. So if you want to buy decals, we're trying to. Oh, by the way, I got a haircut too. No, I'm not a skinhead. I just don't like fucking hair. But I do like my beard. And a lot of people like my beard. So, I'm trying to get a website set up. It's going to cost me a little bit of money, so it's going to be a little bit before I can get the website set up. So I'm trying to do what I can. If you guys are interested in any kind of decals, let me know, and we'll try to get them to you in any way, shape, or form. I don't care what you want or what it is. You know, I can make just about anything that you want to have made. So let me know. I know I have a very small following, but I love the people that I have as my followers here on YouTube. I was actually talking to Lori the other day, Lucky, and I was thinking about just quitting the channel because it's just, you know, I don't know, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to keep making videos. They're probably going to be, you know, they're not going to be as regular as they normally are because I know you guys don't want to see, you know, a vlog every day of what we're doing. That's just stupid. I wouldn't want to look at me every day. I mean, hell, I have to get up and look in the mirror, let alone have to deal with me every day. So I don't want to put you guys through that either. So anyway, just stay tuned. Never know what's going to happen next. So y'all be good and talk to you in a little bit. Later, y'all. All right, what up, y'all? Puddin' here. I'm back. Got another video, small video today. I'm going to show you. I'm going to turn this camera around. It's raining out right now, believe it or not. So I'm just going to make this short and sweet, but I want to show you the two things. I had to go buy something, and I didn't really want to, and I didn't want to pay over $200 for it. So I found it at a swap meet for $35. Or uptown at the swap meet. So I'm going to turn this around, show you what we're going to do, and let you in on the little secret. And no, Rylander, that is not what I bought for $35. That's badass Blue Betty. That's a real man's truck, Rye. So I want you to look. That is a real man's truck. Right here is what I bought for $35. And what we're going to do is we're going to sand it down. I got a little sander. We're going to repaint it. It's a 15-gallon tank. And online, they're from anywhere from 70 for a 10 gallon up to 145. To even some of them are even more expensive. And this is a 15 gallon Blue Boy that we only paid $35 for. And I am not embarrassed to say that's all I paid for it. So, but we're going to sand it down and we're going to paint it so it looks a little bit better than what it does. And then the other thing I wanted to show you. As y'all know how redneck I am, and it's raining, so I don't know if this is going to get on the camera or not, but I want you to look out here what's flying outside my camp now. I went and got the pieces for it, so the old girl's flying. And there's Lucky, staying out of the rain. Then I got another little one to put on the truck, so I have no idea what is going on with my phone today, but it keeps cutting out on me. But I need to wait till it stops raining to do that so I can fire up the generator. I don't like running the generator while it's raining, and but I got to get that done. So I'm gonna let y'all go for now, and y'all stay tuned. You never know what's gonna happen next. So y'all be good. Night country road, take me home. Take me to the place where I was born. Night country road, take me home. To the place where I come from.